What's going on, everybody? Hope everybody's doing well. Welcome to A Percussion Life. My name is Eric Perez. If you are new to the channel, thank you for stopping by. And if you haven't already, please hit that like, subscribe, and notification button just so you can find out whenever we upload. And to all my day ones, thank you so much for all the love, all the continued support, man, the comments, the videos you guys send of you guys playing. Man, you got to love it. And if you don't know, we actually have a Gonga book. It's over 150 lessons transcribed with video links made in a progressive learning sequence so you can learn how to play these drums, as well as we have an instructional video on congas. It takes the beginner to an intermediate level. And also, if you're intermediate, there's a lot of stuff in there for you as well. Very practical, very concise, over 90 minutes long. Those are both $10 each. They're listed down below. And if you only speak Spanish, the instructional videos in Spanish as well. Man, you gotta love it, man. But those are just things that if you are interested, are just gonna help you out in your journey of playing. But yeah, to close off this series on this modern funk, we already did it on one, we did it on two, and today we're gonna do it on three congas. So if you haven't seen it, I'll try to link those videos up here so you can follow along. Please go to the first one. The first one's where you get the feel. The second one is where you start to be a little bit more adventurous. And this third one is gonna get kind of crazy, y'all, because there's many ways that we can actually try to get there. And as well, if you're not a channel member, there's gonna be something in there for the members that you can learn how to kind of take this pattern and the other patterns to another level as well. Just saying, if you are interested, should be a button down below if you wanted to be part of a member, or if you just wanted to give me some love, some thanks, man. You gotta love it. But yeah, let me kind of show you this. I'm gonna build up and then we're gonna explain kind of some of the ideas to do it on three drums. You gotta love it. Can't preface this enough, please watch that first video and also that second video, as we're gonna kind of take the concept of the second variation with some of the movements from the first variation. So that's why those are really important, because it's gonna help us kind of build this out. So just to kind of give you a reminder, and I'm just gonna point out little, you would say, indicators so you can know when we're gonna move to the third drum. But look at the pattern with just the two drums and you'll see on this little indicator. So you remember those little two fingertip taps that kind of help? It's right there, y'all. It's a little bit difficult because you're gonna have to kind of like move around a lot, but that's the best way to practice it. And a great way to practice it is actually using that first variation to just use the double taps there to move it onto the second drum to your non-dominant side, for example. Were you able to catch it? Those two little double taps, the one that you would normally do right there, you would want to move them to the non-dominant side. Since you're already doing that movement, might as well just move it here. Now, the tough part is you have to kind of like, you know, do that kind of thing right there where you're gonna have to get back on time to be able to do those close laps. So think about it this way, is as you're about to approach, then start to make your way back to be able to do the close lap, for example. Did you see that? Did you see how I kind of like climbed back into it? That's how I think it's the best way to help you kind of then move on to then adding that Dumba onto your dominant side. Because once you start practicing it this way, it's gonna be a lot easier to then, when you approach the second variation, which is with these two drums, you're gonna do the same thing with those double taps. You're gonna be able to maneuver in that way. So for example, I'm gonna play it slow so you could see how it's gonna sound. We're gonna play this part slow, then start to kind of incorporate the double taps, the first one, then add in the second double tap and replacing it with this drum. I know, it's a lot. Let me show you. Man, I'm trying to tell you, it's those little moves, those little tricks that kind of get you into seeing these things. Those little double taps really help you, again, with the development to understand just movements, but it's also, by changing it to another direction, adds a melody and a different feel. Now, I hope that you were able to kind of hear that in the midst of that demonstration, how we take in that two pattern variation and adding a third. But how can we avoid just copping out, you know, not doing the double taps? How can we add a little bit more here? Now, another way where I feel like it's not as natural, but you can practice it and develop it, is still maintain those double taps, but because we're still doing some ghost notes and some movement this way, replace those with opens here. So again, a great way to practice this is using the variation, the first one, in noticing when you're not doing those double taps and start to replace them with opens here, for example. All I did was replaced one ghost note, moved it to the tumba, to my non-dominant side, and there you go. You get a little bit more accent. Now, if you were to just be using these two drums and interchanging from that first variation, it would sound something like this. Trying to tell you, this is kind of crazy because now, as we've been seeing, now how will we add that other drum? The same thing, because you're using these same, you would say, movements, maybe an extra double tap for the second variation, but you would just be replacing one of those ghost notes when you're coming back, for example. trying to tell you. It's endless. It's endless. I'm trying to tell you guys. This is crazy. This is some good stuff right here, man, where you can literally take an idea and expand it out to various different melodies and feels. Because if you felt it, it's a lot different from placing those double taps to moving it here. A completely different concept, a little bit more laid back, you know, still melodic, but it's just not as out there as maybe those two opens here. Again, you know, different fields of music require more presence on your percussion, or so you gotta like be wise with it. You gotta be wise with it. But yeah, to play it slowly and counting it, and what I'm gonna try to do is play both patterns here so you could kind of count and see the feel of it.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1.
Man, that's some fun stuff right there. If we were to put that together, play it in real time, it would sound something like this. Man, it's like it could just keep on going, switching it up, moving, taking some parts out. Man, you got to love it, man. But I enjoyed making this little three-part mini series of some modern funk ideas, taking it from one drum to two drums to three drums. Please let me know what you guys think. If you guys want me to do a little bit more of this, taking different little mini series and maybe spreading them out, some ideas, I would love to get your thoughts. Please comment down below. I'll respond. And please take your time. Be adventurous. You know, love the feels, man. Love the feels. But y'all already know what to do. Like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a great day.